Lost Elementary School. Alternate route. No alternate routes available.
Hey, you've dialed Phil and Kim. We can't get to the phone right now, so please leave a message.
Hey, Phil. It's John. Yeah, I'm sorry about yesterday. I kind of freaked out on you, didn't I? Well, look, I'm not ready to meet anyone in any kind of special way, you know, but I would like to take you up on your offer for dinner. I think it would be good for me to just, you know, get out of the house and circle numbers and locations. This location.
I'm sorry, sir, but you need to get back to your car.
Anybody hurt?
A couple of injuries, but nothing serious.
It is the world that has been pulled over your eyes to blind you from the truth.
What truth?
I mean, that's illustration. As the Lord shall come as a thief in the night. Okay, now, those words means nothing if they don't imply what they imply. A thief. You know what a thief does, don't you? A thief is a person who gets what you got. If it's a good thief, they get what you got and you don't know it's gone till the thief is gone. Now, there is no other reason to use that illustration. I mean, I can't think of one. Tell me what the other reason would be. There is a thief in the night. The Lord will come as a thief in the night. Now, one thing that a thief don't want to do is be seen. Then the Lord is going to return as the sun shining from the east to the west, and every eye shall behold him. Now, I'm just telling this basic logic here. You can throw this mess out the door. I'm just saying my logic even makes more sense than that. It can't possibly be the same thing if one is used as an example of the thief who comes and steals stuff, and the other is the bright daylight of the sunshine, and every eye in the world behold it. It's two separate events, just like the angels separating the tares and the wheat at the end and the Lord catching up the saints, or the Lord catching up the church in the air. It's two separate events. And there's no two ways about it. Nobody has said that this is the coming of the Lord. We said it's the rapture, the catching away of the saints. It's not the first of two comings of the Lord. It is the Lord catching away the saints. Exactly what it says. Snatching them out. The Lord catches away the saints. Then the Bible tells us that Jesus returns. There is no mention of the earth. There is no mention of Mount Olivet. There is no mention of Armageddon. There is no mention of treading the winepress and blood flowing to the horse bridle. There's no mention of the Euphrates River drying up. There's no mention. Nothing. Nothing. Just says, we which are alive and remain, after it's clearly taught us somebody's not going to die, is going to be caught up to meet the Lord in the air. He don't touch the earth nowhere. That's not a return. That's coming to do what he said he'd do, which ain't us running. The rapture is the first judgment, brother, on the world that starts the tribulation. Light is removed. And you think this mess is bad now? Wait till the light's gone. And the world has wanted it gone, and God's going to say, I'm going to take it from you. And I tell you what, if I don't come down there and get you, your Obama likes and the rest of everything that does not believe me will destroy the entire world in 7 years, except I return. That's how long these deadbeat, dead brains, carnal-minded, godless devils, take them 7 years to destroy the entire world. When the light, the only thing that has ever restrained them, has now been removed. Now God says,
you get. Have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words.
Leave your body, Seymour. Leave your body.
Left below. Ooh, a He Is Risen production.
Rapture?
Oh, Mr. Thompson. What if your wife finds out?
It's modern times. Everyone's doing it. Where did my Christian limo driver go?
My pious husband is missing.
The baby I chose to have baptized is gone. Mr. Thompson, what's happening?
It's the rapture, Shauna. The rapture. The virtuous have gone to heaven, and the rest of us have been left below.
Left below? Where have I heard that before?
It's the title of the movie.
It's everywhere.
We were fools. And because we rejected God, tacitly accepting Satan, we must suffer through the apocalypse.
I thought all religions were a path to God. I was wrong.
Why did I put my faith in science and technology?
Oh, why did I choose to be gay?
Oh, this movie will haunt me for the rest of my life.